Right now we pretty much have zero visibility.
With the flashlight, it's easier to see the breaches.
1-1 unit. Water commission advised one body on the levee heading towards the brake land.
Hey, station one control. Yeah, it's here 264, heading that way.
Yeah, they're making their way north. They're already past the truck there.
10-4, 272 and myself, we're gonna go into a circle main and then start heading westbound.
Yeah, we're.
This is Sierra unit. If you can just keep it hot on Faisandro so they don't run south.
Copy that, just past the pump house. I got the reds and blues.
Alright, that unit, slow down right there. They're south of you.
Inside a circle?
10-4. Alright, both units right there, you're gonna catch up to them. Approaching them now.
We have a fence on this side. We caught them here. How did they get through? I don't know if they breached. I don't know if they got a ladder. I don't know. We try to be 100% prosecution. So like these guys are definitely going to jail. Just
place. Home is when we're face to face. I got no time to waste. Hold me home. Hold me home. Hold me.
The migrant caravan is growing. The group, fleeing violence and poverty in Central America, has pushed through Mexico's southern border,
trying to make their way through Mexico and head toward the U.S.
Pictures of thousands of people surging to the gates,
sparking a fierce political battle here just 2 weeks ahead of the midterm elections.
Thousands of people began lining up before sunrise to attend a President Trump rally with Ted Cruz in Houston on this first day of early voting in Texas.
Right on the hands.
Immigration has become really important in this race because the Republicans found out that's an effective argument. You know, the Republicans assembled this whole jobs not mobs message. Well, that applied to the Justice Kavanaugh hearings, but it also applies to the migrants coming to the border.
God bless Texas! And God bless President Donald Trump!
What's happening right now as a large group of people, they call it a caravan. And in that caravan, you have some very bad people. And we can't let that happen to our country. We need a wall built fast. We don't have borders. We don't have a country. Our country should be a sanctuary for law-abiding Americans, not for criminal aliens. This will be the election of the caravan, Kavanaugh, law and order, tax cuts, and common sense. That's what it is, common sense.
I've never seen a caravan coming across, you know, in those numbers and traveling in that fashion to make it here. Here in El Paso, we have 95% Central Americans coming across, and they're coming across in family groups. The order was to stop prosecuting family groups. So what do people do? Start coming in family units. That way they're not prosecuted. That way they're not separated. The trek that they go through to come here is horrendous.
There's a human being underneath this uniform. And if my child was in the canal, I would expect a Border Patrol agent if I was coming across to save my life. The fact that they make that conscious decision to enter illegally and not only put themselves but their families in harm is shameful.
We are fully prepared to protect this nation at whatever cost.
Manuel Maldonado Castillo, Mayra Escobar.
Venimos de El Salvador, de Centroamérica.
Dunia Rivera, Ana López Castillo.
Cuando cruzamos el río, caminar quizás unos 25 minutos, cuando nos encontró una patrulla de migración, y luego nos trasladaron a La Hielera, le dice, un centro de detención, y prácticamente 4 días estuvimos ahí. Tenía mi vida, ya no tenía por qué agarrar para acá, pero las pandillas lo hicieron, que uno se saliera de ahí. Nos iban a matar y ya nos tenían vigiadas, porque a mi trabajo me fueron a ver y me dijeron que si había entendido o no había entendido la indirecta que me habían hecho. Ven, vale. Allá quedó mi casa y todas mis cosas. No saqué nada, solo la ropa con la que vengo. Y si la única oportunidad que nos queda es agarrar para acá, porque para otro lado, al lado de Centroamérica, ya no se puede, todo está peligroso.
Es Border Patrol, Immigration Inspection. Fecha de migración, documentos a la mano, por favor.
No se sabe si estando con él lo pueden deportar de regreso al país o le pueden dar una oportunidad, que es lo que todos buscamos, una oportunidad de estar aquí. Que me dieran mis papeles, que me dieran asilo. Eso es lo que yo más quisiera.
Texas already led to history-making moments for this midterm election. Today, we saw some record voter turnout for the midterm.
The Senate race has a lot to do with the big early voting numbers in North Texas and really across the state.
The first day of early voting changed everything. We have a lot of Democrats, a lot of Republicans. If they're voting for Beto, that's a game changer.
If people had shown up at the same levels they showed up in a typical midterm, we would really have no chance. We'll take a vote for anywhere. They live in, you know, Borger or in Gainesville or Houston or anywhere in between.
Desde que empezó el voto adelantado, he estado recabando gente para llevarla a votar.
You got an ID?
Yo digo que Beto nos va a ayudar a venir aquí a este país a mejorar nuestras vidas como inmigrantes, no como delincuentes, porque delincuentes no somos.
Beto, 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 Beto. ¡Arriba, Beto! Thank you, bro.
Se me hace que hay 155 mil votantes activos en Laredo para votar. Todos que están registrados salieran a votar, automáticamente Beto ganaría. Sentimos que él es el líder que necesitamos para ese tipo de comunidad.
Vale, ya llegamos. Tenemos 3 años de no ver a mi esposo. No ha venido. Porque él se vino primero antes, se vino indocumentado y nosotros no nos pudimos venir con él. Vamos a ver a su papá, mi amor. No sé qué va a pasar ahorita.
Thank you.
Ahorita esperar proceso, que uno tiene que ir a cortes y esperar que sea la voluntad de Dios, que no sabemos qué es lo que van a decidir ellos. Es esperar nada más.
What would it take for you to walk 2,000 miles with your little baby girl to come here to this land of immigrants and asylum seekers and refugees, the Statue of Liberty, and to find not that salvation or that safety that you sought for that child, but your worst nightmare, that kid, taken from your arms by force if necessary, you turned over to the Department of Justice, prosecuted like a criminal for the crime of being human? We're the same state that stood up for those kids, for the future, for our best values and potential and promise, and insisted this will never happen again. Not another child taken from another parent. We reunite those kids who've already been separated, and then we move forward. We rewrite our immigration laws in our own image.
He just thrives off energy. He just has to connect with people.
Do not stop till everyone in your life has gone to the polls. And then if you can, come down to El Paso on the 6th of November where we celebrate the victory of our life. Thank you so much.
There's not many things that you can get 1,000 people to come out and watch you do.
Keep it open.
Show up in a parking lot to go vote with them. So if you did ask me the day before the election, what do I want? I want lots and lots of people to vote. We'll just keep him moving, keep him meeting with people and talking.
So many people are emotional, we're emotional. Like, we have to kind of catch ourselves from being emotional as we leave events like this, because there's just so much here. So much good that's happening right now. We're gonna do it. We're gonna do it. I promise.
No poll predicted presidential level turnout. Anything anybody has seen in a poll, I can guarantee you one thing, it's wrong.